السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، حياكم الله جميعا. معايا أخ كندي، هذا الأخ أسلم قبل أقل من سنة، وبعد ما أسلم سمى نفسه شمس الدين. شمس الدين، I want you to tell me about your experience before becoming Muslim, because I know that before you became Muslim you start praying 5 times a day and you start fasting Ramadan, and before the end of that Ramadan you became Muslim. So can you tell me about this experience?
Well, I started investigating Islamic beliefs, belief systems, and the way they live their lives. And after encountering different Muslims, I benefited from what they taught me. So as I learned more, I started praying the 5 prayers. I started even fasting during Ramadan. But as you said, I wasn't a Muslim at that time. But I truly felt the benefit of doing those prayers. See, the way I think of it is that while you're in this world, you live a worldly life. However, when you take the time out of each part of the day and do those prayers, you really encounter God by doing that. You become closer to Him, and that's what we all really desire, to become close to Him. Okay. We know that that's the true way to live, and not just be encountering all these different things such as drugs and, living a poor lifestyle. And, just, mashallah, if you really take that time of the day
and worship
God, you become close to Him, and that's truly your home. This is not our home. This is our home for a short period of time.
Okay. So after praying and after fasting for a period of time, what changed your decision to be a Muslim? Because you wasn't a Muslim. So what was the thing that hit you and make you become a Muslim?
Well, actually during high school, I investigated other beliefs such as Buddhism, and I tried to get closer with Christianity beliefs, but I truly wasn't comfortable with those. But after fasting and knowing that I can do this, a couple hours without taking any consumption of food, that can be quite uncomfortable for some people, but I actually felt really good about it. That, if you can do that, you can really put your mind to anything.
Yeah. Okay. And now you became a Muslim. For less than a year, can you tell me about your experience with prayer 5 times a day? And do you find any difficulties with it?
There are some difficulties, such as praying in the morning, and you're sitting in your comfortable bed, and you really feel at ease. But for me, there's so much more comfort in waking up and not having those whispers from Shaitan. I had one experience of that one time. I was sitting in bed and I felt really comfortable, felt relaxed, and it's just, I felt Shaitan come to me and whisper in my ear, "No, you don't need to wake up. You're truly comfortable, aren't you?" "Yeah, I am kind of comfortable." But I said, "Oh, the belay, I don't want that. I want to get up and pray to God and bow down to God. I'm not bowing down to you, Shaitan."
يعني هنا في الغرب ترى آلاف ومئات من الناس اللي هنا كنديين أو أمريكيين ترى يتحولوا للإسلام بعد ما يعرفوا عن الإسلام. فهذه رسالة لكل مسلم، ترى اللي عندك الإسلام، اللي عندك، اللي أنت من يوم ما ولدت وأنت مسلم، ترى هذه نعمة عظيمة. هنا الناس قاعد يدوروا عليها، ومجرد ما يتعلموا عن الإسلام ومجرد ما يعرفوا عن الإسلام تلقاهم يدخلوا في دين الله أفواجه. ولما يدخلوا في الإسلام زي أخونا، تلقاه الواحد يجاهد نفسه عشان يصوم رمضان، وتلقاه عشان يحافظ على الصلوات، وحتى لو في صعوبات، حتى لو في مشاكل، تلقاه ثابت، ويعني مستحيل يتنازل عن هذه الواجبات، وتلقاه ما شاء الله من أكبر الناس ومن أكثر الناس المتمسكين في هذا الدين. I want to ask you a question. Can you talk to me about loving God and fearing God? What's your point of view about that?
Obviously, I fear God, and I also really love Him, and I know for sure that He truly loves us. We're on the right path. He really loves us. But there's people out there that are on the totally, absolutely incorrect path, not doing what they're supposed to do, not following the laws that will really benefit them and benefit all mankind truly. And so I don't want to be one of those type of people. I want to show Allah that, I'm a good person. I inshallah will benefit from Jannah and not be thrown into the hellfire. And that's where the fearing God comes in.
So this is your goal, that you want to reach Jannah and you don't want to go to the hellfire?
No. And that's why I feel Allah, because a man, he can easily harm your body. Allah, he can harm your soul and your body by just simply abandoning you and throwing you into the fire. I mean, there's signs in this world. The prophets were here to show us the correct path. They are the ones that were truly encountering Allah and benefiting from His word. So these people are truly the ones we need to admire. For they were on the correct path, and they reached Jannah.
Yeah. And can you tell me about your future plan regarding Islam and being a good Muslim?
Inshallah, I'll do courses in Islamic studies, and then by benefiting from that and really experiencing all the different aspects of Islam, learning about them, really investigating them and putting my effort into it. For I really want to do that, put all I can into it. And then by doing that, I can show other people the correct path. And what I'm going to do is, inshallah, go to Ireland, where I'm originally from, and spread da'wah there, and bring people closer to God.
يعني شوفوا سبحان الله كيف واحد يعني رجال ماله ولا أقل من سنة أسلم ودخل في الدين ومع هذا يعني أنا عرفته من يوم ما أسلم من يوم ما أسلم وهو إلى الآن ما شاء الله يعني تلقى يقرأ في الكتب ويحاول ويتعلم ويتعلم أكثر وأكثر عن الإسلام وزي ما سمعته قبل شوية يبغى يتعلم أكثر ويبغى يتعلم عن الإسلام أكثر عشان هدفه إنه يرجع لبلده اللي هي آيرلند ويبغى ينشر الإسلام هناك يبغى يخلي رسالة الإسلام توصل للجميع يبغى يدعو الناس إلى الإسلام شوف الهمة العالية اللي كثير من المسلمين للأسف ما عندهم هذه الهمة فأنا أنصحك يا مسلم وأنصح نفسي بما أن إحنا أصلا ولدنا مسلمين خلينا نقدم للدين وخلينا ننشر الدين مثل ما الهمة اللي عندهم هؤلاء اللي ليهم في الدين أقل من سنة أقل من سنة يقول لك أبغى أنشر الدين وبتعلم عن الدين وإحنا في ناس 20-30 سنة وتلقى حتى أركان الصلاة حتى واجبات الصلاة ما يعرفها وتلقى حتى إنه يدعو إلى الله ويدعو إلى الدين ما في أصلا في قاموسه هذا الشيء حتى الرجل هذا ما شاء الله عليه عنده ثلاث لغات you know three languages right?
Yeah.
You know English and you know
French German.
And German يعرف فرنسي ويعرف إنجليزي ويعرف ألماني هو أصلا تخصصه دراسة لغات فتخيل واحد باللغات الثلاثة هذه وعنده الدين وعنده العلم تخيل إيش الدعوة اللي يقدر يسويها فشوف الهمة العالية اللي عنده and you're planning to learn Arabic as well right
yes I'd like to learn Arabic I only know a few phrases right now and you know I'm learning the letters a lot more I'm able to read the Quran in the original Arabic
so now you can read the Quran in Arabic
yeah and I can do a bit of recitation so I'm getting there
okay good thank you very much for giving me this time to do the interview with you
JazakAllah khair
and may Allah help you inshallah
may Allah be there for you too and may you benefit and may all your friends and family benefit as well I mean
okay thanks